What's up, guys? It's Randy Spider-Man. I guess you could say that. No mask right now, just because it's a quick... I guess it's going to be a quick video. Just talking about the Nintendo Switch, man, and let's get into that. But, you know, first I'll address, yeah, I haven't uploaded a video in over a year. Just been busy with other stuff and didn't know if I wanted to take the channel all that seriously. I am now. There is going to be a new Randy Spider-Man coming out. It's going to be... big ones. It's gonna be like an hour or so long, so that's why it's taken a while. I've been working on it for a couple weeks now, but past that, let's get into the Nintendo Switch. So this is gonna be interesting. As you know, Nintendo did their big unveiling of the Switch, and it was interesting to say the least. It's definitely going to be a very sort of hit or miss console. I can't imagine it doing okay. I imagine it doing either really well or just repeating the failures of the Wii U. Not the trash talk the Wii U, but it just did not live up to expectations of people. So let's go into what we do know, and then we can speculate from there on. So the launch date has been revealed, March 3rd, 2017, in pretty much all the major areas. So that's fairly soon, actually, from this presentation. This is, you know, this happened just the other day, like, what, January 12th? That's, like, not a full 3 months away, even. Not even a full, barely a full 2 months away. Yeah, no, it's not even a full 2 months away. It's, like, a couple weeks away. Now, that is it's such short notice, kind of. It's not as, like, short notice as, like, our buddy the Saturn over here. Like, you know, hey, you guys want the Saturn? Here it is! Like, no, they're not doing that. So, that part is interesting, the fact they're doing it so quickly. But, you know, it's good for the consumers to get us all hyped up. I already know. I mean, decent amount of pre-orders are already sold out on this thing. So, that's it. It's coming out March 3rd, 2017. It's going to be, at least where I live, American, it's going to be $300. All things considered, I think it's a reasonable price. I know a lot of people were kind of hoping for, like, the 250s. I was too. But you really think about the technology, what's included. 300 is... it's appropriate. Although, I'll get into some other reasons, some other things later that's gonna a little bit weird about this. But, yeah, they didn't really give any prices for Europe. They just kind of said, check your local retailer for prices. Like... okay, I'm gonna check the guys who fucking made the console. I don't know, that's weird. This is going to be a region-free Nintendo console. That's a big one, because I don't think Nintendo's done a single region-free home console. I can't think of one. I mean, Famicom and... or, well, I guess there's NES, region lock, whatever. SNES is region locked for PAL, and, region locked technically for Japanese and North American, but all you gotta do is take out the tabs and the cartridges will work in one another. So, I mean, it's a little bit trickier than Japanese. You know, I'm pretty sure you had like to actually like cut the slot or just get an adapter. But yeah, that's the region lock for that. N64 was region locked. It's same thing as the SNES situation though with Japanese and North Americans. Just take out the tabs, and Japanese games will play on an American unit. And it'll be fine. I mean, it's more of a pain in the ass in Nintendo 64's case, but it's whatever. GameCube, region-locked. Wii, region-locked. Unless you do the homebrew hack, which I have done, then it's... but, you know, it's a hack, so it's region-locked. And Wii U, region-locked. So this is the first home console that Nintendo's done that's not region-locked. If you classify it as a home console... me, personally, yeah, I'm classifying it as a home console because of... the battery life on this thing is not very good, but we'll get into that. So, yeah, it's region-free. I'm all stuffy stuff for some reason. I don't know why. But, yeah, it's region-free. And that's good because, you know, Europe gets a lot of games that we don't get. Japan gets a lot of games we don't get. We get games they don't get. And I like playing imports. I just kicked the camera. But I like playing my imports, so that's fine. What else can I tell you? It is looking like there are going to be some kind of color variation within the console, but it's mostly, it looks like just it's going to be the Joy-Cons, like the little handle parts of it. It looks like one's going to be like a red, the other one's going to be a blue. I think they look awful because on top of like just being bright and colorful and just unnecessary, they're it's only for the Joy-Con parts of it. Like, the controller is still gray, or the Joy Grip is still gray, the console's still gray, the tablet's still gray, so you just had these two ugly-ass neon things just going right in your fucking face. I just don't... It's just so pointless to me. I wouldn't buy that. And, it, I don't know, it... To me, it's a Nintendo thing. It's what they always do. They try to do these color variations. They did the shit out of it with the Nintendo 64 Game Boy Color. They did that too. I mean, obviously, I think that's what started it. Like, the whole color. They did it with the Game Boy Color. They did it with the GameCube on top. Besides the the standard black, silver, and purple, there was also that orange spice one that came out in Japan, and just. I think those are the only four major ones for the GameCube, but yeah, it's just a color thing that Nintendo has always loved doing. They're keeping motion controls, and I am probably not going to use those. I don't like motion controls that much. I mean, I don't mind them when they're minor, but when they're just constant motion control, I can't stand it. Like... games like Skyward Sword just become so annoying because of the motion controls. So, I mean, here it looks like they're, like, trying to brag that it's new and improved. We'll fucking see, because I don't have any faith in motion controls anymore. And then, there's Kinect and the fucking... whatever the hell that is, the PlayStation release. I don't even know what that was. I never touched that. I never touched the Kinect either. I just, I've used it at, like, parties and stuff, and it's awful. So, it will have a touchscreen. That was one thing people were really wondering at the initial reveal of it with their Nintendo Direct, I think they revealed it by. And I could care less either way. I mean, it's a home console mostly, so I can't see a reason to need a touchscreen, especially when it has the Joy Grips and all that kind of stuff. And it's not like they're short on buttons. They both have a decent amount of buttons on them, so I can't imagine that'd be something that'd be too useful. It seems more like an item of convenience than anything else, but whatever, it's there. They are going to start charging you for online. That is something very new, and a lot of fans of Nintendo are pissed about that, and, I mean, it's optional, guys. You don't have to get that, and I don't really care. I don't really go online. I mean, as long as they're not doing stupid shit like Microsoft has done, like, yeah, you need to pay in order to use your Netflix account. I already fucking pay for Netflix. What the fuck's I gotta, pay you to have the privilege to go on Netflix? As long as they don't do something like that, I don't give a shit. And though, I mean, Nintendo's network has never been great. But the reason is because they don't charge. I mean, Microsoft charges. Where do you think the money's going? They're not sticking it up their ass. It's going to, besides feed the company, feed the network and make it better. That's why Sony started charging with the PlayStation 4. PlayStation 3 was free for the longest time, my PS3 is still free. But, yeah, the PS4, they started charging. And they had to, because Sony's not doing too good. So they need that extra income, and now they're not great now, but they're getting better, so that's good. So Nintendo's doing the same thing, because Nintendo has not been doing good the last couple years, because the Wii U just did not sell that great. They were doing great with the 3DS. They've always done great with the portables, but their home consoles have been on a decline pretty much since the original NES, except for the Wii. That was the one thing that sold like crazy, and we'll get into why that is, or not even really why that is, the market that bought that. But yeah. So, paying for online, I don't care, whatever, I'm probably not going to do it, but it's going to be there, it's going to be a thing. I can't imagine it being, like, super expensive. It'll probably be competitive with Microsoft and Sony, maybe a little cheaper for Nintendo, I don't know, but, yeah, that's something that's going to be different. Okay, so, I already touched on this, but I'll touch on it again. The, terrible battery life, 2.5 to 6.5 hours, now, that is... fucking pitiful. The minimum. I mean, they say it depends on the game you're playing, and to be fair, I think it'll mostly be in like the 4 hour range, but the 2.5 one, man, that's not good for. I mean, I definitely understand why. It's just, they're really pushing the portable gimmick of this thing, and that is something that, like, because these batteries. I think anyone who's got chargeable batteries knows that after a while, the charge doesn't hold as good, and then they don't, that doesn't last as long. I'm afraid that's going to be the case with the Switch, and it'll get to the point where, like, oh, you can play it on the go for about an hour, and then you better rush to a fucking outlet. Like, they're trying to, they want to get it to last, like, I think for the DS or the game, I forget what it was, I think it might have been the DS, they wanted it to last, like, the flight from, like, Tokyo or something to somewhere else, I forget the exact detail of that, but this ain't lasting the flight, this will barely get you out of state, so that's bad, but maybe, initially it's going to be fine, but I can see down the road that being a problem, so there's going to be that. They mentioned, one of the buttons there is going to be able to take screenshots and capture footage. Now, that is going to be unique because Nintendo is notoriously famous for not being too fond of, people capturing their footage. More so, posting it on social media, which they did say you could share it through. Now, I don't know if that means they're canceling their horrible policies against, like, you know, Let's Players or you know, people who just want to do walkthroughs and stuff. Not that I really give a shit about that kind of stuff, but it is stupid because it is free advertisement and the amount of interest it could garner for your game. I mean, I'm going off on a tangent, but that's dumb, and they might be lightening up on that, and that would be a great idea because it could really help improve their relationship with their fans, especially with games like Mario Maker. Fans could upload all the interesting levels they've made, and people could try to recreate it. It would just be, it's just in their best interest to do that. I think they're doing it. I really hope that it's not like some kind of Nintendo specific social media sort of thing, like some kind of Street Pass, whatever kind of. I just hope they just go full on embrace the social media, because you're just going to alienate your fans if you don't do that. Times are changing, Nintendo. I mean, you guys have never been that great at evolving. Now is the time to evolve a little bit more than you have been. Innovation is good, but evolving is also good. Up to 8 Switches can be connected at once through just local Wi-Fi. That's a lot of people. And considering that each Switch can have 2 controllers, and you're looking at 16-player multiplayer, and I think they did something like that for Smash on the Wii U. I don't have that, but I think they did something like that. But this is, like, locally, everyone around. I mean, I can't imagine I'm going to know 16 people ready to play a Switch game. I can't imagine I'd know 8 people ready to just, like, line up and, you know, hook up our Switches and let's go. But that's cool, you know, having just more people, making more of a party accessory, whatever, that's fine. I don't think Sony or Microsoft does anything like that. So, you know, the more merrier. Clickable sticks, I mean, that's kind of a given at this point. Yeah, we can expect that from pretty much anybody at this point. Interestingly, when they revealed all that stuff about the Wii U, or not the Wii U, the Switch, it does not seem like it comes with a pack-in game. And I'm trying to think, when the last time that Nintendo did that? I know a lot of older, the NES, I'm pretty sure, came with Mario. Wii came with Wii Sports. Wii U, I'm pretty sure, came with Nintendo Land. Just, they're not doing a pack-in with this game. And I guess I get it. I mean, it would have benefited them if they did include one. But that would raise the price, and it already is at a pretty competitive price point, especially for, like, new technology. So I guess including a pack-in game would really kind of perturb people from buying the console itself. But they're gonna buy a launch game anyway, though. So that's a tough one. I guess it'd be easier for a consumer to accept the 300 than it would be to expect the 360, because then they'll be like, oh, it's too close to $400. Even though they're going to buy, you know, another game without a store, what are they going to do? Just stare at it? But, you know, whatever. That's whatever. I don't care about that. No packing, whatever. I'm still going to buy games for it, so it's not a big deal. It's not, if it makes the console cheaper to not have a pack-in, fine. Especially because their pack-in would probably be something that I would not want. I don't care. So there's that. Now let's get into just some speculation, or just things I notice, and then we'll go into the games that are coming. So they barely mentioned the Wii U at all. They did that whole thing about, oh, this, the Switch is the culmination of all Nintendo's past hardware, which, you know, is bullshit, because, like, when they got to the GameCube, like, ooh, the GameCube had a handle. Even then, we were thinking about portable. That was so fucking stupid. Now, you could have just said, the GameCube gave you two sticks. That would have been fine, you fucking idiots. That was dumb. But yeah, they barely mentioned the Wii U at all during this whole presentation. It really seems like they're trying to get so far away from what a failure the Wii U was. And yeah, I don't hate the Wii U or anything. It's fine, but it's just, man, just because it didn't sell, they're dropping it pretty hard. I guess it makes sense from a business standpoint. It wasn't very detailed, though. They were really thinking about this could be a detailed look at the Wii, at the Nintendo Switch. But it was more so just kind of focused on the Joy-Cons. Like, ooh, they're thingies! Look at them, they're thingies! Oh, that was all they did, really. And I learned some new stuff. I learned all the basic info I wanted to about, like, you know, when the console comes out and the titles and all that, but you didn't learn much about the specs. Not that I'm really that kind of guy who's like, oh, the processor's not strong enough for me. I don't really, as long as it's fun, as long as I can enjoy it, that's all I care about, but, you know, not very detailed, and I don't know how overheating is going to be with this thing. I imagine this thing's going to have a fan in it. Or maybe not, it's a card, I don't know. No, it might not actually have a fan in it. But it has fans. I don't know if this thing has a fan in it, Nintendo. Why didn't you tell me? So there's that horrible translators. At least for Sega's people. I think it was Sega's people. It was just painful. Painful. There's a minute where the guy is seriously, the Japanese dude is talking. And he's just, you know, Koichi, Nanakasai, I don't speak Japanese, but he's talking, the translator's like, it's my, I really want to bring you guys this console, it's going to be a great gaming experience. Like, it just, wow, fire that dude, that was terrible. I mean, being a translator's not easy, but come on, dude, it's your job. So there's that. It doesn't look like it's that much more powerful than the Wii U. Again, I don't really care about that, so that's just whatever, just a thing to notice. I already said the color controller Joy-Con things don't interest me at all, unless they actually, like, go all the way with it. Go fucking give your console, like, make it all blue. Don't just do, like, sides, make it all blue. Make all of it blue. Then I'll be more interested. I mean, because, yeah, I'm not a fan of, like, every fucking game console now just coming in black or sometimes white. Like, that's what I liked about the game. It was purple. Like, it had some fucking color and some life to it. They don't all have to be fucking black and lifeless. I like black, but come on, dude. I have black bookshelves. You can't even see half of my consoles, because most, or more than half, like almost all of them, because almost all of them are fucking black. Let's get some goddamn color up in this bitch, and not shit colors like this neon shit. The straps, they're doing the straps thing for the motion controls with the Joy-Cons, and they seem pointless, but whatever, I guess it's a safety issue. I really wish that this whole motion control thing wasn't such a big part of the Switch. I mean, I don't think it will be. I think it's just going to be for a couple games to appeal to casual gamers, but it's just so annoying to see that. Yeah, please include the strap for me, Nintendo. I'm going to use it all the time to fucking jerk off. They shouldn't include shit like that. The fucking straps, they shouldn't include that, but I guess they have to for legal reasons. I just hit the tripod again. Man, I'm an idiot. Alright. HDMI out, which is, you know, no shit. It's kind of standard now. It'd be shocking if it didn't do HDMI out. If it did fucking, like, component or composite, man, people would be pissed. It'd be really stupid. It'd be really, really stupid. They said three play styles. Now, I'm assuming they mean, you know, tablet, controller, or, you know, tablet motion controls. But is that it? Is there, you know, screen and motion controls? What if I take, you know, it out of the docking station, I set it up like a tablet, but I want to play with, like, the Pro controller or just the other controllers? Like, can I do that? This kind of begs a lot of questions. I mean, this thing offers a lot of variety in how it's played, which is something I love about it, just the innovation in it, but can't be more detail. There was no detail in this. Like, really? They didn't really explain that much. They just said, this is when it comes out. This is what it costs. These are the games. Pre-order it now, motherfucker. That was it. And because it's portable, is it going to come with... Is I guess this might be a thing. Third-party gel cases? Like, they have those for the Wii U's gamepad, which makes sense. So, would they do that for the Switch? It might be a little trickier because, you know, the Joy-Cons come off. So, every time you want to take a Joy-Con off, you got to take off the gel case. But, I mean, this thing's, if you're going to use this thing portably, it'd be nice to have one. Because I can't imagine these things are, like, super durable. And something like that, like, that's the whole console you're taking with you. You drop that and it breaks, you're fucked. You can go home and stare at that working docking station all you want. It ain't going to fucking do anything. It's not going to work. So... that, I hope, becomes a thing, because I will totally, because, I mean, my wife wants to take this thing everywhere, and I told my wife, you, no, I don't want you to, just, please, don't, because, I have DS, I have Game Boys, tons of games for them, take them, have fun, babe, but I don't want you taking this, especially when it's new, it's $300 to replace, so, you know, please, do gel cases, and because of the whole portable aspect of it, is this going to be the end of the DS line? Because this is a hybrid. It's portable and home, so are they going to... I mean, Wii U's obviously ending. Is the DS going to end? The 3DS going to stop? Or new 3DS? Whatever the fuck's in it now? Is that going to stop being a thing? Because... I mean, that would suck. I can't imagine it would be too much, though, because Nintendo... you know, they always kill it in portable, so I can't imagine they would just up and, like... you know, say, all right, fuck portable games now. We're just going to, you know, stop doing that. It's all going to be Switch. They'd have to do some serious marketing. And I can't imagine you do that because it's a portable because it's battery life. So I don't know if the DS line is going to end. I would guess not just because of, you know, financial logic. But well, I guess that's the thing we'll see. And batteries. Okay, I had a question about this, and I actually was able to get this answered. Is the Joy-Cons themselves, you know, the two separate parts, they're powered by something, so where are they getting battery? Or do you need to put, like, AAAs in or anything? Thankfully, no. The answer is, you can charge them on the docking station, which, for that, I mean, that kind of sucks. Oh, wait, no, you know what? It doesn't suck, because it also charges via the Joy Grip, and it has a little cable that plugs into the Switch that you plug in and charges, so... it's kind of just on the level of PS4, Xbox One, so, yeah, okay, that's fine. I was really worried at first that was going to be an issue, but, alright, so, those are just overall speculations from me, and now we get into the games, the titles that were announced. We'll go with the first one that was announced for the Switch. It is 1-2 Switch. This pissed me off so much. I got so mad watching this because I was just feeling repeats of the Wii. It is so painful to see Nintendo trying to repeat the Wii. Yes, the Wii sold well because you appealed to casuals, but that was in 2007. It's or 2006. It's 2017 now. Give it up! The reason the Wii appealed so much to casual gamers is because it offered something new and easy to use. Motion controls are not new anymore. They're fucking everywhere. And they're a million times better elsewhere. And they're not going to bring in people. I mean, people are playing shit on their phones now. Their phones have motion controls on them. Why the fuck are they going to buy? Are they going to buy the latest hardware for shit they could do over 10 years ago? It's so stupid. And on top of that, you're not even... this is a pointless game. Because you don't even look at the screen in this game. They're like, you stare directly in the eyes of your opponent. What? Okay, then why is this a video game? Because you're really missing the video aspect of it. Why don't you just give me a fucking board game or a stopwatch? Like, oh, who shot first? Is it rock, paper, scissors? Stupid shit. It's a game that you don't even look at the fucking screen for. What the fuck are you wasting my time with this stupid shit? I was so worried that this was going to be a pack-in game. Thankfully, it's not, because if I got that, I would have thrown it straight in the fucking garbage. That is a stupid thing. but it's not a pack-in game, thankfully. It's going to be a launch game, though, because, you know, the people are clamoring for that. You know, some people are probably looking forward to that. I think it just looks so awful. It's so stupid. And it's not... Hey, guess what, Nintendo? It ain't going to capture any sort of fucking casual gamer at all. It's not going to do anything. They're not going to give a shit because they're still playing Pokemon Go. They're playing games on their cell phones now. Shit they couldn't really do back in 2006. I mean, yeah, you can play Breakout and shit. Now they're playing Pokemon Go and Angry Birds and all, and fucking Mario Run. Give up. You fucking just give up. You want to appeal to casuals, put some of your cell phone games on a fucking cartridge and or card, whatever, and release it that way. So that, I hated that. I hated it so much. I'm never going to play it. If someone buys me a copy of that, I am going to punch that person because that is a stupid fucking game. The next one was another motion control gimmick game. It's called Arms. At least it looks more creative. It looks like something out of Wreck-It Ralph, but... do you look at the screen for this one? Because if you don't look at the screen, I'm not interested. And it's, I mean, we already had this. We did Wii Boxing. Again, like over 10 years ago. So, I mean, I'm not clamoring for it. It looks better than 1-2 Switch, but, you know, it's nothing I'm demanding to go out to get. I mean, I would prefer if they did that and it was just like a Punch-Out clone. It's creative looking. And no knocking it for it. I love the art style in it, but, yeah, I'm probably not going to get that one either. Alright, next was Splatoon 2, and it looks fun. That's it. It looks like a fun game. I mean, first Splatoon's a lot of fun. This one looks more or less the same. So that's probably going to be pretty good. Now, here's a big one. Mario Odyssey. Now, this looks pretty awesome. I love the imagery of Mario in New York City. A lot of people are saying, it really reminds me of Sonic Adventure and Sonic 06. Like, I got that vibe too. I really felt more like Mario was missing. It reminded me of Mario was missing. That's bad. But it's interesting to say at least. I mean, it is appropriately titled Odyssey. It's so weird seeing Mario with real people, especially in 3D. I don't think we've ever seen that for him. I like that they're going back to that sandbox style of gameplay like they did with Super Mario Sunshine and Super Mario 64. Galaxy kind of really wasn't that, but I mean, I love Galaxy, but yeah, I like that because those are the Mario games that really kind of captivate me. Like, I love going, like, you know, level. I mean, Mario 3 is one of my favorite games, but I do like that kind of adventurous Mario feeling. So that is something that should be pretty cool. I'm interested in the hat with the eyes. It looks like it's going to be, it looks like a Minish Cap sort of thing, but it's also, it's not going to be a launch game, unfortunately. It's going to be a holiday game, and, I mean, I wish it was a launch game for obvious reasons, but yeah, it does make sense to release it around the holidays. It's going to sell, and, yeah, I'm looking forward to that one. I'm definitely going to get that. It looks like a lot of fun, and Nintendo almost always delivers on Mario games, at least, so I'm looking forward to that. And here is where it went into rapid fire. It became really hard to follow. Not as hard as it gets later, but, yeah, I'll try to go through them. Xenoblade 2 just looked gorgeous. I mean, I never played any of the Xenoblade games. I really want to. I heard nothing but great things about them, and it looked amazing. Like, the art style, the voice acting just looks beautiful, and I really want to try that. Next game was Fire Emblem Warriors, and this one fucking blew my shit. I was watching this with my wife, and I was looking at the swords, and I was looking at it, and I'm like, I'm pretty sure these are Fire Emblem swords. She's like, they're not Fire Emblem sword. Like, I'm pretty sure that was Crom's sword. And then when we saw Ike's sword, we were like, this is Fire Emblem. And then the theme kicked in, the done. And we didn't know what it was. It's still like, you know, you just see Crom pick up the sword and that's it. And they didn't say what it was. When they said Fire Emblem Warriors, it's like, holy shit. Because, I mean, I'm fine with the Fire Emblem game in general, but Fire Emblem Warriors, that means they're going to give Fire Emblem the same treatment as they're giving Zelda with Zelda Warriors? Thank you. That is going to be so much fun. The only thing that's got me a little perturbed about this is that I'm pretty sure they're going to mostly focus on Fire Emblem Awakening and Fire Emblem Fates characters. I can't imagine they're going to focus too much on the older games, and that sucks for me because I like the older games way more than Fates and Awakening. I mean, Fates and Awakening are fine, but I just love the older games. I mean, I'm sure you'll get to play as the Lords. Like, you'll be able to play as Ike and Marth and Roy, probably Lindis, Hector, Ellawood, probably Ephraim or Erica. I don't think they'll give you both, maybe. But I really don't think they're going to focus too much on the side characters in Fire Emblem Warriors. I believe more that I'll be able to play as, like, Tharja from Fire Emblem Awakening than I would as, like, someone like Skrymir from Fire Emblem Radiant Dawn, who is a much more main character, but, you know, whatever. I'm sure it'll be fun. You know, maybe, you know, extra DLC characters if we plead and beg hard enough. So, I'm looking very forward to that game. That should be so much fun. Just, oh man, that's gonna be great. And now Square Enix has a game, Dragon Quest Heroes. Never played any of the Dragon Quest games. Hear good things, so it'll be great when it comes out. Then Shin Megami Tensei was revealed, a new Shin Megami Tensei game, and never played that series either. A good friend of mine always gives it glowing recommendations. It's a weird, at least what I saw was weird, like dick monsters, but I'm sure there's a reason for it, but it'll probably be good. It'll probably be fun. Next was Project Octopath Traveler. Now, I love the design of this game, just the look of it, this sort of 3D mix of old-school RPG, SNES kind of graphics. It just looks gorgeous. It looks, like, so interesting. And it might be fun. It might be more old-school, but I like old-school RPGs, so I think I'll like it just fine. I might get it. I don't know yet, but I've definitely had my eye on it. And then Sega showed up for no reason, really. They just came to show up and say, we like the Switch. And that's it. They were just there as a PR stunt. Maybe Sonic's coming. I don't care. Sega has not been good in, oh my god, god no, over 10 years at this point. I mean, great. You gave Yu Suzuki the rights to Shenmue. Can you guys do anything else? Like, fuck. Can we get Panzer Dragoon Saga sort of ported? But, you know, that's a whole other story. But, yeah, Sega, no surprise, is probably not going to do much with it. They don't give a shit about games anymore. They're far more interested in Japanese pachinko machines than they are game software. They don't give a shit, really. I mean, there are homebrews and, you know, Dreamcast independent games that come out. And Sega could easily go after these people, but they don't. Because they don't fucking care. They're fine. So, them showing up was just like, yeah, whatever. And then Bethesda showed up to confirm Skyrim is coming to the Switch. Now, that is going to be pretty cool. One thing that's interesting about the Switch that I need to touch on is the opportunity that it presents to third-party developers. Because whether you want to admit this or not, third-party developers have gotten lazy. They don't like taking risks. They don't like taking a shot on something that might not work. I mean, that's what these episodic games are becoming now. They're becoming test games, basically. Like, we're going to release level 1, and if enough of you buy it, it'll fund level 2. That's what it's become. It's become more of being cheap, I guess. It's a bad way to say cheap, but it's a more cautious way of doing business. I don't like that because it's just, just go all out, man. It just pushes people harder and harder to make a better game. But whatever. But that's the point we're at with third-party developers. And this is interesting with Skyrim coming to Switch, because Skyrim is not a new game at all. It is a decently old game at this point. So this is an interesting way for Nintendo to get more third-party developers, but for third-party developers to not have to keep developing new games. A lot of third-party developers now can just take their older games and port them to the Switch, and then it becomes, I mean, you could argue whether or not that's the best version, we don't know yet, but it also gives those games the benefit of being portable. Like, that's the big thing that people want, is Skyrim on the go. Now, that is cool. That is very, very cool. So, in theory, you could do that with a lot of games. Nintendo could go after third-party developers going, Hitman Absolution, you guys made that in 2013? On the Switch. Yeah, put it on the Switch. You know, go ahead, do it. Put it on the Switch. And you guys get double money from one game. It's an old game. Now, that is an interesting position to be in as a third-party developer. I mean, yeah, you have to spend money to, you know, get the cards made and all that, but the benefit for that is you don't have to do any work, really. You just gotta do that, and that's it. You're making money off the same game again. So, and for people who don't like digital stuff, I mean, they can go after digital-only games and put them on the Switch, make them physical. That offers a lot of promise to people. That could definitely be something that interests people because they can just, you know, not have to deal with that shit. So I think this might be a running theme with the Switch, is the re-release of old games. And you know, people can complain all they want, like, oh, it's just old games again, they're not doing it yet. Yeah, I hear that, I really do, and I understand that, but Nintendo needs third-party developers. They didn't have it on the Wii U, they didn't really have it on the GameCube. They had it on the Wii, kinda. The Wii had a bunch of shitty third-party developers because the major third-party developers did not want to deal with this fucking shit. And GameCube, the disc couldn't hold enough data, so a lot of people jumped over to Sony and Microsoft again. Nintendo 64 cartridges, and third parties bailed, so this is a chance for Nintendo to really get third parties in here, and let's hope they do, because that would be great, because we need more third party supportive games on the Switch. Or, I should say, we need more third-party support on a Nintendo console, because they could really benefit from that. If they got Square to give them the new Final Fantasy game, or even get the remake of Final Fantasy VII, Nintendo would be doing great. The next game is I have no fucking idea, because the translator was so terrible, I had no idea what that dude was advertising. You're fired. And then EA showed up to show us FIFA. Oh, thank God. I was so worried there wasn't going to be a sports game on my Nintendo platform. So yeah, I don't give a shit about FIFA and that fucking smug cunt on stage. I even named my son's middle name is even Luigi. I love Nintendo. I've always been supportive of Nintendo, except for the Wii U because that was shit. But I love Nintendo. I love them, except for the Wii because that was also shit. But I love Nintendo. Fuck that guy. Fuck is it been smug, whatever the fuck. Patrick, whatever your name is, go fuck yourself. And then they went into ultra rapid fire mode and then just showed a million games at once and it was hard to take them all in, but there's gonna be a Dragon Ball Z game. It looked like Dragon Ball Z Xenoverse, so that's gonna be cool. Lego game, a Sonic game, Just Dance, which is also a launch game, along with the Skylanders game. So that's fucking, what are the launch games thus far? Skylanders, Just Dance, and 1-2 Switch. Not a very good launch setup. Possibly what looked like a new F-Zero, and F-Zero has been dead, I think, since the fucking GameCube, so hopefully that is a new F-Zero game, and let's do it. And I think a port of Mario Kart 8. Now the big one, the big reveal that was not really a reveal, but more so just when, is they finally showed off more of Breath of the Wild, Legend of Zelda, New Zelda, and I am so excited for this, because it's the first Zelda game in a while that has really, like, really looked like almost nothing can go wrong. Because, I mean, I liked Skyward Sword okay, but the controls of that game are just fucking terrible. Just awful. And I really didn't care for the world that much. It was just so, like, limited. Like, oh, three levels almost, basically. So I didn't like that part of it. And Twilight Princess, I mean, everybody loves that game. Everybody just adores that game. I don't really care for it because, to me, that is like the pinnacle of just lack of creativity in a Zelda game. It was just so standard. This does not look like it. This has a whole new feeling. This has a wonderful art design, and I'm really interested in just how, just with the vastness of the world. I really can't wait to explore that. And I didn't want to do that in Twilight Princess because the world was boring. I didn't want to do that in Skyward Sword because it was just a pain in the ass fucking jerking off everywhere, flying. And as much as I love Wind Waker, and I fucking love Wind Waker, there was no real big open world in it. It was the sea. And I don't have a problem with the sea, but, you know, every now and then I want to be on land and explore. So this looks promising. Voice acting. Most of it sounded fine, but the one big one where I have to side with those people that I hate that always go, the Japanese is better, because half the time they're saying that because they don't understand it, and they just like, yeah, we're anime fans and we like the subs. But one thing that really kind of sucked for the English dub of the game was Zelda's voice actor, and I'll just say this real quick. Cause I love Zelda's design. It's not my favorite, but it's different, and I like that. But yeah, her voice actress, she sounds very Snow White Disney princessy, and I don't like that really. And she just doesn't have as much emotion as the Japanese voice actor, especially with the scene where Zelda is like breaking down and crying in Link's arms. The Japanese voice actress makes it seem like something really, really went wrong, whereas the other one's like, I didn't get to go to the prom. So hopefully that. Please do another take of that. I wasn't looking forward to that. But and then they reveal when Breath of the Wild is coming out, which is going to be the launch day. Thank fuck. One, because if this got delayed anymore, people would burn Nintendo down to the ground. And also, give me something worth buying. Now, I don't know if that has mass appeal to, what's it called, casuals? But, it's going to interest me. I'm going to buy it. Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah, I want that. It's going to keep me occupied for a while. So, overall, that's the Switch presentation. Odd, but I'm still interested in the console more than anything for Breath of the Wild. I mean, it's just, that is the game to get right now. So, that's it. Next Stranding Spider-Man is going to be out very soon. So, I'll see you all later.